Hey friends, welcome back to another week at Children's Liturgy. We hope that you had an awesome Halloween last night, even if it perhaps had to be a little different than other years. We hope that it was a good Halloween for you, and we're excited to have you here with us today. Today, we're going to do a few things a little bit differently. So the first thing is I want to challenge you to see, you're probably going to recognize the gospel. When we hear our opening song, I want you to see if you can maybe guess what the gospel is. In fact, if you go to one of the schools that I worked with, last year we even started talking about this particular gospel passage back in February, and then we were supposed to finish in March, but guess what? No school, never happened. So see if you can guess what our gospel might be based on our opening song today. So friends, we're going to head to our opening song, and I will see you a little bit later.
God blesses those who are poor, theirs is the kingdom. God blesses those who mourn, they will be comforted. God blesses those who are humble, they will inherit the earth. God blesses those who hunger and thirst for justice. Oh, 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 oh. Jesus went up to the mountainside. God blesses the merciful, they will be shown mercy. God blesses whose hearts are pure, they'll see God. God blesses those who work for peace, they will be called children of God. God blesses the persecuted, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Oh, 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 oh. Jesus went up to the mountainside.
Please join me with the sign of our faith. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. We love you, God, as members of your family. We want to show you our love by living as Jesus did. In your name, forever and ever, amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. A reading from the first letter of John. Brothers and sisters, see how much God loves us? We are called children of God, and we really are God's children. We know that when Jesus comes again, we will be like him because we will see him as he really is. Everyone who believes this tries to be good and pure, just as Jesus is good and pure. The word of the Lord.
See how much God loves us. That's one of those words, one of those sentences we heard in that reading, right? In fact, that's where it starts. What a reminder for us. See how much God loves us. We are God's children here on earth, right, friends? Now, that's not the same way as when we say Jesus is God's son, that Jesus is the child of God. But God has chosen each one of us to be his children too. It's pretty special if you think about it. God chose me, he chose Jonathan, he chose you. You're his child. And just like your parents love you, God loves you too. We hear at the end of our reading today that everyone who believes this tries to be good and pure, just as Jesus is good and pure. So friends, our challenge is to remember to be good and pure as best that we can. We're going to hear more about the good things that come from that when we hear the gospel in just a couple of minutes here. Now today, we're going to do something a little different with our gospel as well. So we're still going to have our psalm and our alleluia like we normally do, but today our gospel is going to be a video. So you don't have to stand for today's gospel like normal, but we should still stand for our alleluia as we hear it. So we'll head over to our psalm and then time for our alleluia and our gospel.
God's story, the Sermon on the Mount. So part of God's story is about a sermon Jesus gave on the side of a mountain and what he did afterwards. And it goes like this. One day, when Jesus saw crowds gathering to hear him teach or see him do miracles, he went to the side of a mountain. It was near the Sea of Galilee, across from a place called Capernaum. From there, he gave a message all about God's kingdom and his love. We call this message the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus started by explaining who would get blessings or favor from God. He said the most blessed people are those who are poor, sad, or humble. He said God shows favor to people who are just or treat others fairly, and people who are merciful or show love to those who don't deserve it. He said the people who are pure, who bring peace, or who get hurt for doing right will be rewarded for their actions in heaven. In other words, the people who love others, even when it makes them seem weak or unimportant on earth, are like heroes in God's kingdom. Anyway, Jesus went on to explain that when we believe in and follow him, it's our job to show everyone else who he is by loving them. That means going out of our way not only to comfort and help our friends, but also forgive people who hurt us, love our enemies, and give to people in need. The thing is, Jesus didn't just talk about love, he showed it all the time. In fact, right after giving this sermon, Jesus spent the rest of the day helping everyone he met.
Well, happy feast day to all of you that are joining us today, and what a great celebration we have today in the church. Or throughout the whole year, we celebrate the mighty workings of God in individual people's lives. We celebrate particular saints. However, today the celebration is oh so much bigger. Today we celebrate what God has accomplished in the lives of all the saints, both those known to us, those whom the church has formally recognized as in heaven, and those unknown to us, those who are in heaven but have not been declared saints by the church. It's like the biggest, bestest party you've ever been to. It's kind of like a little foretaste, a little glimpse of heaven itself. These saints are those whom God has declared blessed, and by doing so has made them blessed, made them happy, with an inexpressible joy and happiness, as we heard in our gospel today. These saints are our brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. And you know what? Okay, come in a little closer. This is important. You and I are also to be saints. You and I too are to be saints. And that's not just something for a time far off and for kind of something after we die and things like that. No, that's to be like right here and right now. Already, God has given us everything we need to be living heaven right here and now, to be saints. For what is impossible to us human beings, God makes possible. If we want to be saints, if we want to be filled with the joy and happiness forever, then we must love God, by whose love we become saints. So let us seek the face of God, who, when we were baptized, became our Father in heaven. And so trusting in our good Father, who empowers us with his Holy Spirit to do the impossible, to live in our heavenly home forever with him, where, with our brothers and sisters, the saints of God, we will rejoice forever in the goodness and mercy of God. Well, thanks for joining us for another week here, Children's Liturgy of the Word. Again, happy feast day, and we look forward to seeing you next week. And so, here's our closing song, so up we go.
In my wrestling, in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore. Peace in my trouble.